two centuries, the Shauna Corporation has used borrowed futuristic technologies to provide Traveller, Python, CG, Skyrim, and bikini videos for the subscribers of this YouTube station.
Everybody in here, give a holler if you have any questions.
Well, this will be my last Skyrim video for a while. Skyrim as we know it. I'll probably do slideshow videos in the meantime. Mm-hmm. I know I'm going to be doing more Traveller videos.
Until next time.
Maybe 3D modeling stuff.
I'll be happy to assist.
Maybe.
What can I do for you?
Programming, you know, Python programming type stuff.
Is there anything else? We
shall see. What other hobby of mine fills the void where Skyrim used to be?
We sell bows at.
So the plan for me and Jesse to go to Falkreath. She's gonna escort me to Falkreath. I'm going to bump into Arissa. Arissa's gonna come with me during the moment I become Dragonborn. Because she seems focused on me, you know, becoming Dragonborn when I meet her. So I might as well roleplay the part. She doesn't seem to care about any other quest except for the main quest. And the beginning of the main quest. Once she thinks you're Dragonborn enough, she wants to do her own quest, and Daiji tell her, that will have to wait. And then she's just a regular follower for the rest of the game, because she doesn't really do much after that. But I thought I'd let her hang out with me at the beginning of my playthrough, because I haven't used her in a while. She usually sits in Falkreath the entire playthrough, and she's like, hey, there's something I want to talk to you. Can I talk to you for a minute? There's something I need to talk to you about. Hey, you know, she does that every time I go into Falkreath. Yeah, dead man's drink.
Hello, friend. We sell bows, arrows, and ale. A unique combination.
I mean, so I was curious what he has to offer. I think he only sells a longbow. I already have a longbow.
Let me know. I might have it stored away.
Unless I've gotten rid of the longbow by now.
What are you hunting? Never mind. I don't want to know.
Okay, yeah, he's got longbows, imperial bow, nothing. I mean, this is the beginning of the game, so he's not going to have a whole lot of junk that I don't already have. We're about even, Steven.
Thank you very much for your business.
Yikes, I messed up just now. I was recording over the game audio instead of my own audio track. I've never done that before. Hopefully my voice is still in this video at the beginning.
We sell bows, arrows, and ale. A unique combination to be sure.
This blonde guy, he's sitting in his chair for the first time in a long time.
Bark.
Yes.
What can in my last playthrough, he forgot what his
Woman, you'll be the death of me yet.
He forgot what his what do they call that?
Be seeing you.
His sandboxing. He forgot how to sandbox in this place. So he would just stand in the corner.
Fear and nothing of remorse. Pay my fee and together.
He wouldn't sit down and eat or cook or do anything. He just stood in the corner. It's very strange.
Walk always in shadows, so that you will see your foes.
That's because I made him live at the Bathing Beauty Luxury Suites, and when I told him to go back home, I think he lost track of where he's supposed to live.
If you have need of hunting,
you go on ahead.
Then you've come to the right.
Yeah.
Oh, did you need something?
I put Shanae back in the game. I thought I might use her as a companion in this playthrough. Because we're both Imperials. Just this once. That's the plan, at least.
I understand.
She's a bit too young. Too young, eager. What else? And she's overpowered for her size. She can take out an army. Because she's some sort of battle mage? She insists on using her battle powers instead of any kind of weapons I give her.
You've done well. Of course. How can I argue with that? You've done well.
Yeah, I guess she likes me.
Hello, friend.
Think you might be in the wrong place. He had to come upstairs to see what's going on. It's just that if I'm gonna be going from here to Falkreath, I need to have my wits about me. I can't be thinking about sex the whole way. I have to be focused like a laser beam as far as skill advancement is concerned. Because if I'm distracted, then I can't improve any of my skills. In fact, I want to say my skills go in reverse, it seems. It takes forever to level up. Oh, yeah. I can brawl with this guy.
I can tell you're no stranger to the wilds. I'm sure we can meet your hunting.
What?
So I thought I'd save first before I do the brawl, in case my game dies or something.
Yes.
I've never brawled in Azeem before.
Teach you to mess with me. Come on. Is someone there? You're tougher than you look. You got me. Fair and square. Fine, I'll take care of it. Just please leave me alone. Then you've come to the right place.
So I thought he'd change, but no, he's still the same.
Something you need, you miserable wretch.
See, now he hates me.
Leave me alone.
So now he talks even more mean to me. And I can actually brawl him again.
I actually advise the Jarl on political matters. My input is invaluable, of course. But this is all probably a bit over your head. If there's nothing else, I really do have important matters to tend to. Do you get to the Cloud District very often? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you don't. The Jarl has no time for idle conversation with travelers. The Jarl has things under control. Don't you worry. Why would anyone join the Stormcloaks? They have a fraction of the Empire's wealth and power. I look forward to the day when this rebellion is put down, and we once again have peace.
I'll have to fight him again one day.
I hate people who waste my time.
You lost?
See if his relationship goes down further with me, because then that would mean he'll try to kill me on sight. And then he'll end up dead. See, right now he's a rival. He's not a foe. -2 would be a foe. That would mean his death. He signed his own death if he goes to -2.
If you have need of hunting supplies, then you've come to the right place.
Okay, we better get going.
An archer, eh? I've got just what you need. Thank you very much for your business.
What can I do for you?
I was looking for somebody else that I thought might be here.
We sell bows.
Sophia.
A unique combination.
I remember now. Sophia doesn't stay put. She roams around pretty much most of Whiterun.
Yes.
So she'll be here for a bit.
You want something?
She goes to the blacksmith for a bit. She goes to other shops and she goes to the tavern. That's always neat when NPCs walk around and do things. I was trying to get the old lady to say something to me because, you know, she's in my bubble. Because now I have a bubble.
Come to chat with an old woman, hmm? Do your good deed for the day.
But I think she already walked through my bubble.
Do you like horses? You should visit the stables. I own them, you see. And our stock is excellent.
So I have to click on her now to get her to say something else because she's already told me all this stuff. So I kind of know her already. So she's flagged as somebody that has met me already. I don't know if that's a Skyrim thing or if there's a mod that tracks that kind of stuff.
Talk to my father, Skolvar.
Because you know, with the kids, according to US or UESP, the kids have tracking, which I didn't know. Kids know if they've met you for the first time. They know if you've met them once. They know if you've met them more than once. They know if you met them after their parents died or not. It's kind of neat. I don't know where those variables are kept or who hangs on to that knowledge. If it's you or if it's the individual NPCs that remember that stuff. So I don't know what the names of the variables are to look for them. It would just be something like a child has met player equals 1, or child has met player equals 0. Child has met player first, or first time meeting player, you know, something like that. And it's usually just a flag, you know, 0 or 1. And there's a whole score of these things. These are global variables. Global variables, I want to say. Did I just spin around when I talked to her from behind my back? That was weird. I don't think I ran out to Falkreath this late in the day. I probably waited till the next day to continue on. Oh, there's already a fight going on. There's already a fight in my game. Why can't I just go through a Skyrim playthrough without any violence? Whoa. Just scratch. I just want to see who these guys are.
I'll mount your hand on my wall.
Ooh. That all you got? I just had a battle axe go across your face. Is that all I got? Basically, she's saying, "Thank you, may I have another?"
Yes.
Oh, he's got a new face.
Aye.
That's neat. I like that face. That's cool. I've never seen that face before in my game. Who's on fire over there? Oh man, this person got charred. Cooked. I don't have wet and cold installed, so burn shock freeze effects should show up more often in my game now. I'm trying to lock in on this guy. I can only click on his horse, though. I want to know where he came from. Like, what? Or I wanted to move him back to me. I had something to say to him. I can't remember now what I wanted to say at the time. Oh, can I get a lock on him? Oh, don't get stuck on the... I want to call these things telephone poles, but they don't have telephone poles. So he's level... What was I looking for? Oh, I was looking for his inventory to see if... Did he take her stuff? Doesn't look like he took her stuff. I can't read. I'm using a small thumbnail, so I can't read what was in his inventory.
I'm right behind you.
Who took her stuff? Or his stuff? The burnt guy. How come he's
what
naked?
What you got there?
Why is the burnt guy have nothing?
Lead on.
It's probably the girl that took the guy's stuff. Maybe the soldier took the stuff.
You're tired, friend. The Bannered Mare has beds for rent.
And the reason why my character is running this way is because I have movement speed something something installed. So all of the movement speeds in the game, all of them are adjusted. So instead of your character running around like a 60 mile per hour SUV on off-road vehicle kind of thing, your character just runs at the speed of a normal person would run. Takes a while to get anywhere. It might be lame if you're used to running it, you know, at freeway speed.
What do you need?
What is it, Imperial?
But after a few nights of trying it out, I got used to the new speeds in my game. Horses got adjusted. Animals got adjusted. I think they did. Doesn't use any scripts or anything. Oh, swimming is really slow now. You're no longer a speedboat. You know, you're no longer a hover... What do they call those things? Hydrofoil. You're no longer one of those hydrofoil boats. You are slow as molasses when you're swimming anywhere in the game now. So I'm an Imperial, I'm unknown. People respect me though because they assume I'm law-abiding. Anyway, that's the end of this video.